Hi, welcome to Aurora DPT. Today we're going to break down a topic that gave me gave me a lot of trouble in PT school. We are going to break down supination and pronation. So pretty much anything about the foot came very hard for me. I had to break down a lot of it, and with other classes to study for, I only grasp main ideas to kind of keep my head above water. We don't want you going through that, so let's break it down a little bit and help you learn more efficiently. I'll also put in a link to a video that helped me a ton with everything about the foot, the biomechanics of the foot, down in the box below so that you can check that out as well. So, let's get started. So when we think about the foot, we need to first break it down into the cardinal planes so that we can grasp the idea of pronation and supination after that. Pronation, supination is actually a triplanar motion, so let's first get to the cardinal planes. Let's look at the sagittal plane first. So when we think about motion in the sagittal plane at the ankle, we'll think about plantar flexion and dorsiflexion. When we look at the frontal plane motion, we'll see inversion and eversion. And then when we think about the transverse plane, we will think about adduction and abduction. In the real world, in reality, we will see that triplanar motion of all of those things put together. It's very hard for your foot just to act in one plane in real life, and so that's when we see supination and pronation in the clinic, and that's what you'll hear comments about in the clinic in documentation, because it's so hard to isolate one or two of those motions. When we think about supination, think of the word soup. A good analogy to think about is scooping the soup. So supination is going to be a combination of these three motions. When you supinate at your foot, you're actually creating a more rigid foot biomechanically during gait. And so one thing to think about is that this is going to produce more force. So think about plantar flexion, getting those gastrocs, getting that gastroc and soleus involved. We are going to be able to produce more motion during gait and get to the toe off. Using the word force production can actually cue you to remember supination equals plantar flexion by getting the FP, force production, also PF in plantar flexion, so PF, FP into supination. Now, pronation of the foot is going to be opposite in that instead of producing force, it's going to absorb force. So when you think of someone with a flat foot or someone with a lot of pronation, whenever they're accepting weight through their foot, it's squishing down and flattening out, then think of all of that force being absorbed through the ligaments, muscle, and even bony structures. Try this. Try standing up at your desk. Push into dorsiflexion by pushing your weight forward towards the balls of your feet, and notice how the arch of your foot starts to flatten out as the weight is being accepted. So use this as a cue. Moving into dorsiflexion is going to create that pronation. So one way to really hammer home these concepts and all of the planes that the foot is moving in with supination and pronation is to create muscle memory. While you're studying this topic, move through supination, move through pronation at one ankle, and really get repetitions of this motion so that when you think supination, your foot and brain connection will tell you, hey, this is what it looks like, so that you have another external source that'll help you. So when crunch time hits and you're in the middle of an exam, you have that other source to help you out. Keep exploring what the world has to offer, and hopefully we'll get some more videos out soon to help you with your study habits. With boards coming up soon, good luck to those of you taking tests.